All right, what is up, everyone? This is Bo from BZ Hub, and I am doing my first mic over, I guess, of actually playing the game instead of putting in the audio afterwards. But as you can see from the main menu here, Lions are available. It's not the beta anymore, and we're gonna give it a try. I'm gonna warn you, the grandfather, or whatever his name is, he's gonna start talking. Yep, there he goes.
The Western Reserve. You'll remember it for the big plateau, the one with a view to die for. That's where you find the potholes that Barden mentioned in his note. There are plenty of places along the river to check for signs of Barden. The first spot is marked on your map.
I have four bullets right now. Let's see, okay, so I thought there was going to be a mission involved with Become the Lion. That's a normal one. Maybe you have to finish the main mission? I'm not really sure. The main story missions. This is gonna be something we find out over time, I guess. This is one of my favorite places to get Cape Buffalo, but maybe not lions. I've watched the streams of where they're hunting lions, and it's kind of obviously the savannah and stuff like that, but there's also trees. Usually they're kind of running around trees and whatnot, but I don't ever remember them showing where they were on the map when they were doing it. So I don't know. Lion right there. Kidding, it's probably a tree. Okay, well, we'll go to one of my favorite spots. Don't know if it'll be a good spot for Cape Buffalo, but we'll give it a try. Let's see, is it this one? I think it's this one. Obviously need to get more ammo for the King Zenith. I'll have a video coming out of racing to get the King Zenith yesterday because, lions were coming out and I didn't really have a rifle to hunt them, so this, I'm getting a vibe. This isn't the place. No, it is. Okay. Just want to make sure. I don't have the full metal jacket yet. Really close. But we'll get some of these bad boys. But yeah, as I was saying about that, King Zenith is my favorite rifle. Growing up, hunting, you know, all you can think about, I guess maybe I'm just a weird kid, but I was always that guy who was growing up wanting to be like the big game hunters in the savannah, hunting in Africa. So, you know, being able to have this double barrel rifle has definitely been one of my favorite things about Call of the Wild. And I played the Hunter Classic a lot. You know, as I talked about in some of my past videos, I was almost dev with a Hunter Classic, designed the trophies for that in one of their community design competitions that they used to run back in the day, but it'd be really cool if they put those out again. I really enjoyed those and it gave me something. Oh, look at this. Look at this crazy guy. It's not stopping. Oh, shoot!
You've got the hunter.
There we go. At least we got a lung shot on him. Oh my god. Stop. What is going on? Invincible buffalo. I love K-Buffalo. Okay, so we got a headshot right at the very beginning. His face stopped the bullet. Her face, sorry. Got the spine there, but of course they changed how the spine works, so that doesn't stop them anymore. I'm not really sure what you do to stop a charging buffalo now. Do you have to try to go right for the brain? Because it doesn't seem to go through the skull very easily. I guess that's something new about the buffalo. Here's another one. We'll give it another try. We'll go for the lungs this time. See if it's any different. Oh, he didn't. At least we got that one. There we go. Maybe that was a hard shot too. Maybe they're running from lions. That would be nice. See, there we go. We got the double lung. And yeah, looked like it was going for the heart. But this bullet doesn't have any penetration, evidently. Just all damage. So that's okay. I really hope they didn't just totally nerf my favorite rifle, but we'll find out, I guess. Especially, did I unlock the other bullets? You guys probably watched it already, and you probably know, but I don't. I wasn't watching. So this lake is one of my favorite places to be. Always seems to be a lot of Gemsbok. Sometimes lesser Kudu are always down in this little meadow here. Sometimes you get the scrub hares. It was hilarious on our safari in Zambia. We saw scrub hares, but it was only at night. I swear, never saw them during the day. I don't know if it was just because I wasn't paying attention to them or something. But I never saw them during the day. It was always at night. Let's see, that was a kudu. I wonder if they fixed the kudu's horns. I haven't really been watching everyone else's videos, especially when they played the betas. I watched a little bit of Ron McTube's. He was doing that. But I haven't really been paying attention to see if anyone else noticed the kudu without the horns. I thought the first one I shot that I noticed it, I thought, oh, this is an oddity. And then as I kept shooting them, I realized that no, it was a bug. And I'm usually, you know, when it comes to the hunter, I'm an entomologist. I love the game no matter the bugs, because you know, it's a big game. So if a map is buggy, then I just play on another map, and I, you know, the developers are gonna fix it. They just need time to fix it, and so I don't whine about it. Not to say that people in our community whine, but if you follow Facebook, that becomes apparent. Oh man, I thought that was a weird sound, and I was like, whoa, what was that? Just a kudu. Okay. Running around like a crazy person. Maybe, and you're probably all like, you need to go to this side of the map. That's where they were. And I know that the stream today, I don't even know if they ended up getting one. I think they ran around looking for one for a while and then never found one. And I think in the Trailblazer, the beta, they did make a mark about how... Oh, let's see. That's a male, and it doesn't have horns, so didn't fix that, I guess. They did come out with a lot of other fixes, though, so I can't be too picky, you know? I was never really a big fan of the lesser kudu anyway. Oh, there's a buffalo. That looks like a pretty big one, too. That's gonna be too far. Maybe if I can get on this other side of the hill... correction, too far for that little bit of space right there. I would have definitely taken a whack at him. Out of breath now. Yep, he's going downhill. Well, we'll run around in this area for a little bit. I gotta keep a tab on the time. We're at about 10 minutes right now, so... We'll run around for another 5, maybe 10 minutes, and then I'll go to another area to look for the lions. That way we kind of get a good spread of the map doing all of this live. I just want to make sure we get the best chance we can get, I guess. Oh, look at them all. We're supposed to be looking for lions, but... Oh, no. my equipment bugged out. Oh no, doing me dirty. All I did was try to switch my binoculars so I can check these puppies out, but the hunter has other plans. So it looks like there's a kudu way over there. Oh, there's a bunch of them. Bunch of kudu over there. Bunch of Cape Buffalo right in front of us. No way to access our weapons. Okay, well, I mean, it's getting dark anyway. Let's switch back to... Oh, I want to check out these light. My cursor doesn't show up either, so I'm going to check out those lakes. Let's travel here. We'll sleep. Although a lion hunt at night would be interesting. And extra scary. Maybe we should try that out. I got our guns back. Okay. What about binoculars? Gonna bug out? Nope. Okay. Well, I guess we can check up here while we got them out. Nope. No Leones. There's a Gemsbok. I'd saw in Ron McTube's videos that he had shot a couple of lions next to water, so I was hoping maybe. I always seem to find a lot of things next to this water over here, so. Oh, I better check to see if I got that new ammo. I'm not sure with the lions if penetration would be better than flat out damage or not. Ah, dang, okay, still haven't got it. So anyway, we're gonna be forced to use it anyway. All we need is a lion. King Zenith, almost half health. It's looking good. I do have the perk that, you know, decreases the damage that the, you know, charging animal or something will do to you if you shoot at it. I'm not sure what constitutes damage. I guess damage is pretty simple, but I don't remember if it's actually shooting the animal or just shooting at it, I guess. Would be the best way to describe that. But we'll run over here. Do you think the lions, are they quick to run away? Or are they not very scared? I know that on our safari, the leopards, obviously is a national park and they see cars all the time. So it's not like they're running away from it, but like the leopards did not care you were there. They would just stand there and they just said, yep, I'm gonna go my way, just avoid me, let me do my thing. And you know, I guess Vurhonga is you know, it's a reserve, I guess, a little different than a park, but makes you wonder. I'm hoping that, just in the midst of all this running, I hear one. I'll turn the flashlight on. I don't really like having the flashlight on at night. One thing's for sure, if I do find lions, I will definitely put it down in the description where in the video I saw them. That way, if you kind of want to skip to the action, you can definitely do that. But for now, we got lucky with some head-on collisions with some Cape Buffalo in the very beginning, and we are still looking for some Leones. Simbas. Oh, there was a sound, a crazy sound there. Isn't anything worthwhile, though. Kudu running, maybe? Look like a kudu, anyway. Not in the mood for kudu. If a Cape Buffalo, I haven't really seen any Cape Buffaloes in this area, but if I do see a Cape Buffalo, I'll go after it just because I love Cape Buffaloes. Maybe I'm attacking this from a different, not the right way to do it, I guess. Maybe they're hearing me and running away. Or maybe I'm just not seeing them. You know, I'm sure other people have shot some today, so I can't really say that. But there was one time in the Hunter Classic where they were putting out bighorn sheep, and they released them, and all the hunters went out hunting. I think I hunted for like 3 hours that day. I walked in the game. I walked nearly like 2 miles in the game because it's a giant map, that Rocky Mountains kind of map. Come to find out, they never actually got the bighorn in the game. They just said they released them and then actually didn't get them in. If you were playing, you know, the Hunter Classic during that time, you probably remember that, because that was... Oh, that was a disappointment. I really thought, man, I'm not good at this game. I do not see any of them anywhere. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Right in front. Simba male. Oh, he's sneaking away. Get back, Simba. I'm gonna reload real quick. I don't know where he's going. That was kind of a pot shot. Oh, he's running off this way. Nothing like running around in the tall African grass. Oh, and we did get him. I'm gonna slow down just because I watched the videos. I saw it. We're down to 75 to 50%. Around a bush or something. If any of you played the Hunter Classic, you probably remember like bears. It's a good one. They would get injured and they would like go and lay down and then wait for you to get there, and they like pop up and do like one last attack. I don't know if that was a feature of the game or if that's just like what happened, but they always did that. Down to 25 to 50. He's kind of running into some trees up here. I was really looking forward to them attacking me, though. If I died, I really wouldn't look forward to them, to me running all the way back. So better keep my eyes on the prize here. Get a little sidetrack. Oh, okay. So we're down to 0 to 25. Oh, we're getting in some really tall grass. Though, judging off the size, you'd think you'd still be able to see them in this tall grass. That was one... Oh, look at that. One thing on the savannah. Never saw a lion. Oh, and of course he lands in the tall grass, so we can't even take a look at him. There he is. My first Simba. I'm going to have a terrible trophy. The quick kill bonus is definitely low, and I don't even have full consecutive harvest. But yeah, he's a level 7 there. Look at that. Wow. Did get the lung. Did give us 100 integrity bonus. I was wondering about the weapons, you know, whether they would want us to use a 7mm or not, but I'm glad I have something else to use the 470 on. King Zenith. All right, King against the King. Nice. Cool. First lion down. Should we go to daytime? Because as much fun as I thought it was going to be, you know, getting attacked at night or something, he just kind of ran away. Oh, I heard something. Of course, I don't know where he is. Definitely heard some sort of a growl of some sort. Didn't you? Whoa. See, now I have a little bit of fear setting in. Here we go. Where do you think... Let's turn this off. Maybe we'll be able to see better. So, I don't know if you all heard it. Maybe I was talking. But I heard, you know, the grumble, what is that called? I don't even know. The thing that the big cats do. The... Is that supposed to be their call, or was that just a sound I heard? There's a gemmy over there. Get the rifle out, just in case. So I should look for tracks, maybe. Maybe that would give us a good idea of where they might be. Ooh, kind of scared me for a second. Oh, here we go. Oh, we got a female now. Oh, heard him. Heard her. I know once I say something about it, I'm going to get attacked, but I remember when the K-Buffalo, when they were attacking everyone like crazy, and so they dialed it back, and they were like, okay, oh, there's a gemmy. And then the K-Buffalo would run away from everything and hardly ever attack you, so they had to change the setting again. That's kind of how I'm feeling right now. Feeling like they had the Trailblazer beta and changed the aggressiveness, maybe. And now they're running. But maybe I'm running around just like a crazy person and they're like, nah, I'm not gonna deal with that. Seems like I'm trying to get low so I can see anything in front of me, but I'm not like exactly sneaking through here either, so I mean, if it's gonna run for me, this is the reason to do it, because I'm freaking running around like a crazy person. I was really hoping they would just turn around and charge, though. Is it charge with a lion? Oh, the tracks stopped. Interesting. Did she make a turn somewhere? Oh, no, that was the last track. Whop out my handy dandy notebook. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So I know it says to go forward. Well, maybe she went closer to the water's edge. Otherwise, it really seemed like it just stopped, didn't it? I'm gonna pause. All right, we're back. I had to do an audio check. My mic was being spotty a little bit ago. And after all that action, just wanted to make sure it was working. I wouldn't have to like start over or something. So look at that. More tracks. Don't need the notebook anymore. Dang it! Ah, we switched from the lion to the Gemsbok. Well, maybe we'll run by some lion tracks on the way back to our last track. I'm guessing she's long gone, though. You know, we were hearing her. Wait, now that looks like the poop. That's lion turd right there. Just now, too. All right, so she's about. I never saw anything about whether they kind of group up in like a little pride of some sort. Sorry, I just saw that up there. Nothing like chasing a lion and then deciding, hey, I should look at my binoculars. Oh, here we go. We're going this way. Saw some springbok up there. Did you guys see that? Did everyone see that? Sorry. Oh, what's that? Stupid springbok. Heard her. Where is she? Ooh, there she is. We're chasing her. She's moving. She's making a weird hoof sound right now. But she does seem like she's in a weird, like she's not just doing, oh, there she is, way over there. Oh, she's running now. Love the King Zenith. I feel like Alan Quartermain or something. League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. There we go. Here we're taking pursuit now. God, she is just... She had a big meal earlier. Look at that. Boom! Same as the other one. I'm just not getting good penetration with these rounds. Alright, so this one... You're always going into these stupid bushes. Okay... I just want to be able to see what's in front of me. Don't think we landed that second shot though. Okay, so we got stuff that way to over there, it looks like. Did she go full circle? See, she did. Okay. Hit to you 75, bleed rate low. Roblo. Okay, going this way. There she's going, she's still pooping. Just now. That's not a lion. Oh, she's probably like behind me right now. I have a feeling she's gonna stop bleeding. Okay, so she's at a 0 to 25 right now. There she is. Sorry, she wasn't highlighted, so I was second guessing myself. Look at this. And not in tall grass. We can assess. Wow. Look at those chompers. That is impressive. Say yes. I have to say, Cecilia, if you're watching, great job on the modeling. I'm gonna feel bad if you didn't model these, but I'm just so excited by the whole thing. So we've got a male, we've got a female. This is great. We're making great progress. Based off of the aggressiveness of those two, I'm gonna vote do we stay in the area? God, this is difficult. Because, I mean, we've got two. How many do you think stay in an area at the same time? I don't know. But let's go to daytime. So at least they're easier to see. I'm also all the way back to the starting area. Let's head, which way is the wind blowing? So if we do that, the wind will be blowing right. No, it won't. We'll be going west. Yeah, okay. Let's do that and then walk to the lake at 6. I love this. I'm going to be putting a video out just to let everyone know. I'm going to have a comparison video of my safari versus Vurhonga Savannah. It's going to be pretty cool. I realize, you know, this area, I don't know if this is supposed to be like Tanzania or something like that. They make a reference to Nyami Nyami, which is the river god of the Zambezi or Zambezi. I never did. I heard everyone say different things. I don't know which one it is, which I'm not sure how many countries the Zambezi runs through. And to top things off, I was in, I wonder if we unlocked those bolts. No, I don't think so. I never did see anything pop up. Did you? Really not looking for the unlocks, so maybe they did and I just wasn't paying attention. Okay, so we're going to be heading west. And the wind changed when we traveled and the time went by, obviously. Okay, well, that's not too bad. We'll just not count on hunting anything to the north. Lions, of all things. I would assume they have a pretty good sense of smell in this game. But anyway, turn off the flashlight now. I'll be doing a comparison of the safari. I'm gonna be talking about the tents. Gonna be talking about the bathrooms. I'm really gonna try to do my best to talk about everything. I love the acacia trees. I think that when I see them, I think of Africa. At least I think that's an acacia tree. I don't know, but. We'll start walking. Maybe they really were running away from me running. So we'll start walking. Maybe we'll have a better chance. Especially with other animals. It's daytime now, so maybe we can spot them from far off. I don't have the 338. I've unlocked it, but I haven't bought it yet. I was literally saving up all my money for the King's Eagle. And I got it. So I'm a happy camper, because, as you know, King Zenith is king. So there's a wildebeest. I won't feel as bad shooting that with the king. Zenith. What is Zenith? It seems like a space term. I love saying it, though. King Zenith. All right, we made it to the road. What is that? Halfway. Should we go to the markers? You know, two birds. With one 470 round. Probably stop. See if we can bag ourselves a kudu. A hornless kudu. I guess that one is hornless anyway. In Zambia, there were greater kudu, I guess. We only saw a female one, and it was really far away. But, you know, that's okay. Still the idea of it. I have just noticed that the brush. And I got one of the skills, if not both of them, to decrease the amount of sound I make going through brush, but the audio going through my headphones makes me seem like I'm a lot bigger than I am. Ooh, look at this. Okay, so I'm gonna say it looks like something's standing there. We got a feed zone. That female kudu, I forgot to look what the gender was. That's another one. Okay, yep, nope, that's the male. Okay, you know, it helps when they have horns. It really kind of makes it a little easier to tell which one's which. Should be paying attention to the tracks too. And let's run this way. Up the hill, run up the hill. Where are we? Are we close? Yeah, we're getting close. Probably not gonna find a kudu or a lion out in this open nastiness, but once we grab this rock, we'll head down to the lake. Maybe we'll find stuff there. We'll look for big poop. We'll look for paws on the ground. Prints, mind you. Gosh. Whoa. They jumped right over this. Looms over Vurhonga like a lion at rest. Maybe the lions recognize that, and so they're gonna hang out by the plateau, looming over the grass. Well, nothing, just standing out in the open. It must be so hard for the development team because I know since the Hunter Classic, I've been looking forward to hunting in Africa. And I mean, I started that, oh my gosh, I think my freshman year of college. So that, oh goodness, that was probably 6 or 7 years ago. I'm not going to try to exaggerate. Probably 6 years ago. Okay, where are you? There you are. Alarmed. Probably because there's a Yahoo running around. But they finally got an African map, and I'm so happy for it. I'm having a great time. But the entire time I play, I'm just thinking, oh, you should add this. Oh, you should add this. Oh, you should add this. And I'm at the point where I'm just like, Africa's a big place. Just add another African map. And I know you're all probably like, no. Add turkeys, right? Hashtag add turkeys. And I've hunted turkeys in real life my entire life. And so, I don't understand that, addiction, but turkeys are fun. I understand it. But as soon as they maybe get a desert map, a good desert map is something I've always, also looked forward to. Get some pronghorn or get some desert bighorns or something with some elk, something like Nevada. Is that, do they have, all those things, right? Pretty sure. Kind of gets into some timber and then gets into some deserty area, almost like Colorado. If you're from Kansas like me, you have to go through the eastern part of Colorado to get to all the good stuff. And eastern Colorado is a lot like western Kansas, and it's very boring. But sometimes you see pronghorn, and that's okay. I like pronghorn. Is that a wildebeest? It is a wildebeest. And another kudu. Ah, I'm just marking off objectives that I don't even know I have. Dang, buddy, you're in. Welcome to the big league. first official gig is mad easy. This guy is with the current lingo. Hook me up with a photo of Thvakil Kvi, the dirty lake that Nalbulo cleaned. Wait, is it? Was it? Oh, I heard a lion. Is that a lion? Did you hear it? Or was that like a weird, like, I don't even know. Oh, right there. It is off. I realize if I got shot, I'd probably run away too, but I'm really mad. I wish they would just come to me. Okay, I will check our back to make sure. Don't get a larger one. Gonna start chasing us from behind. Let's see if we got a hit on this. Oh, I saw a blue mark over there, so it kind of threw me off. What is that? So it's a jackal. Okay, I was like, it's kind of small for a lion, but where is it? Where are the marks? It ran this way, or I saw it run this way. No way there's not tracks for it. Just gonna act like it wasn't here. Did it go up here? Oh, I heard it again. Let me know in the comments if the audio for the game is too low. Cause on my next playthrough, I'll turn it up. Okay, well, so there were no tracks of it running. There's a kudu. Didn't really notice any tracks back over here, but we will take another look, I guess. It's that wildebeest. That's the kudu. Oh, there's stuff running. My finger got in the way when I was sliding my mouse. Ah, darn. Okay, we're just gonna forget about that guy. Okay, I'm not crazy, right? We saw a lion. And it ran this way. Is this the poop? Lion poop? No. Did I go? I didn't go too far, right? That was right there. I can see where my tracks were. This is rubbing me the wrong way. Backwards. So you all know. Okay, well, you know, I'm just gonna follow my gut. It went this way. The game does not agree. But I know. And I swear when I was over here, I could hear it again. But it's probably running away from me because I was running around. But I didn't get a shot on it. Does that look like a path or no? Looking for a trail it may have made. Despite there not being any tracks. There we go, okay. Buddy. Thought she was gonna juke me out for a second. Oh, that was some major musculature attached to that tail if that bullet hit that. And then we got the spine there. I was going for the lungs, but I guess we got the spine. All right, wildebeest down. Oh, there she is. Oh, she got me. You know what? I'm honestly not even mad. I'm actually happy. I was really excited to get attacked by a lion. There we go. Oh my gosh. She was so fast though, and my bullets, my aiming, I should say, correction, was not very good. Did I ever unlock the bullets that I need though? Actually, I'm probably using the right bullets because I'm not sure. See, expansion's at 100 there versus 23. So if they're gonna be running at us, we probably want all the expansion we should get. We should get, we can get. All right, you know what? Four-wheeler, going back. We're gonna get that lion one way or another. Let's go green. I'm feeling green today. Just like the grass, we'll blend in. Oh, we are green. The whole thing, I haven't bought any outfits. Like, I was literally in a race to get the King Zenith before the lions were out. So we did that and we've succeeded twice and failed once. So we're doing okay. I don't want to say anymore because I feel like, yeah, I'm not going to say it. Not going to say it. Bad juju. I'm guessing this is the right direction. It's starting to pour. IRL. Right. Gonna get a lion. Okay. Well, now that we've been knocked down by one, not killed, we're still going. We've just been knocked down. Rush to a hospital. Shit. Shista. Obviously meant. Look at that. Look at that. Did my bullet get her? Look at that. Look at that. I obviously did enough. It's like when I fought the cougar with the 20 gauge slugs. I was trying. That's all I had at the time. You had to fight the puma in Parque Fernando. And all I had was 20 gauge slugs at the time, so I was just like, you know what? Yeah. Look at that. Still got the right lung. I was gonna say, you'll be able to actually see where I shot her. It's slowed down, slow motion, but I didn't know at the time. I just saw that. Alright. Good. We're not continuing on the four-wheeler. We're running through tall grass. So I had about 24 minutes on the one half. I shouldn't call it half. About halfway now, because about 24 minutes now. Let's go. What's that? Saw some rocks or something. So the lions like staying around, well, no, I can't say that. No, I guess I can, because I was around that one lake and then the kind of spread out from there. So they like lakes, it seems. Like being around the lake. Well, we might go back to that one area that we got the Cape Buffalo, because there's some thicker trees around. Oh, why did I do that? I didn't mean to do that. You know what? Might as well go up it now. Wow. Look at that. We can shoot out of there like someone who shoots out of here. Look with our binoculars. Whoa, there's a whitetail. Sounded like the bleat. Or is it a grunt? Ah, oh, it's a grunt. Darn. Yep. Go. As if me getting in here triggered the arrival. Why use any other weapon? Try to get a good broadside shot here. Hurry up. Good deal. I swear, the running in the game, they use like the same audio for the animals versus the penetration is low on this round, but obviously small animal. Well, we never discovered that one. Should we run up here? Actually, we could check out this lake. It's got some forest, probably around there. You go to this tent. I have a tent around this lake. If you all don't have a tent around this lake, I highly recommend it. Watch, there's gonna be like nothing around this lake, but usually there is always something around this lake. So we'll see. Of course, I'm gonna sprint over here because I'm short on time. I want to make sure I get as much content as possible. Okay, we'll walk. From here, let's see what we got. Gammies. Oh, some. Oh, that's a. Oh, never mind. Sorry, they curl up. If I was on the safari, though, that would have been a good one. Let's see. So, that one's running. That one's a 4. Has anyone found a 5? That's like a simple YouTube video away, but seriously, I have yet to see a Gemsbok at a 5. There's a red one. That's pretty. Usually pretty quick to shoot Warthog when they got some good old tuskers on them. But these ones don't. Ooh, that one's not bad. It's a 3 though. It's raining, my dog's scared. Just a second. Oh my gosh, they can hear everything. So we are looking for lions though. Oh, what was that? Oh, more warhogs. I'll try to talk over the jingles. When I get a video, we'll have Bjorn in the video. Bjorn's fun. That was one of my favorite things watching World of Warcraft videos with, oh my gosh, what's his name? Swifty has the Rottweiler. Oh my gosh, love that. One of my favorite parts. Okay, I don't think we're gonna have any luck with lions around here. I don't see any. There's a lot of herbivorous animals around here. We could take a pot shot at some of these Gemsbok. And you're thinking, no, just use the scope. But why would we use the scope? Here we go. We'll lay down. That's got to be, what do you think? 270? Well, let's see. Do we have? No, we don't have. I was going to say, we could get that skill to switch our... But no, we missed. Ooh, I saw where the bullet hit, though. We were close. These guys do not care. They're closer, too. I'm gonna get the red one. Oh, I shot over it. Are they bugged out? What are they doing? I think they're bugged out. Oh, I might have missed that one. Because they're not running. Okay, we'll leave them alone. That's not fair. They're fixing bugs too. If you all got the update of what's going on, you saw the things they're fixing. Sometimes when you fix things, sometimes other things don't work. What are we supposed to do when we get here? Oh, I'm sorry. Take a picture of the lake. Okay. Well, and we got these bugged warthogs here. We're gonna have the sickest picture of the lake anyone could ask for. Look at all these warthog. Oh my gosh. Get the logo out of the way. There. Oh, he's gonna be so impressed with that shot. $1 million shot right there, buddy. This is how it's done, chum. Next up, I got a variety pack. Look at this guy. He's like a little dog. Hello. Got some spine action there. Got some more spine action. As you can tell, I was kind of aiming a little high, but that's okay. I hate this. The whole examine trophy. Or examine the trophy. Okay, so we, thanks to some bugged warthog, do they attack you? Nope, they don't. Okay. Thanks to some bugged warthog, we unlocked the penetration bullets. See, look at this guy. And he's a 3. Look at those tuskers. He's pretty. Let's take a picture. I never, like... they popped back up. Oh, God. Oh, what is this about? I don't know what to think. They're like statues that attack me. Oh, they're all staring at me now. Okay, we're gonna get out of here. We're gonna go back to that area where the Cape Buffalo were, and if not, we'll go to the bottom left area of the map, southwest corner. Gonna keep this to an hour and 15, but I believe we're at 58 minutes right now. I just kind of wanted to look over the edge here. Always good when you're up on these high points. That's the best part of Vurhonga, other than the animals, obviously, and the King Zenith. I mean, there's a lot of things that's awesome about Vurhonga. Definitely my favorite map. Is having the opportunity to take these long shots. It's awesome. And that's another thing I'm looking forward to about a desert map. Is having big points like this. Wow, did we get freaking stuck in a little spot there? Having high points to take long shots. I don't know what large animals we would hunt in the desert though. Not sure. Get some, maybe you could have like a plains area. You could have like a plains area in the desert. Have some bison. It really could be a eastern, well, I guess it could just kind of be like a Colorado kind of thing. It gets split it up into some thick timber and some prairie and some deserty areas. Coyotes and bison and bighorn. So we're gonna try around this lake here. Got some gimmies in the background here. Darker one. If for some reason I did see something of diamond quality, I'd probably stop the lion hunt for that. But I think I run around too much to see that kind of stuff. So far the only diamond I've got is a wow, I am blanking. The antelope, the small ones. Oh, there's a five. Okay, so we got a lion, and it's a male. We'll stop running. It's chasing something. Could it be chasing one of the buffalo? Oh, what's it doing? Oh, okay, here we go. As long as they, okay, so we got big buffalo. We'll get down. Let's get over here so we can see. They'll probably run. I'm pointing with my finger that you can't see. I'll probably run right down here and go to the right. So we'll stand over here. Don't know whether to take a shot at him though. Don't want to scare the leon. But I mean, if the lion's not afraid of Cape Buffalo, then don't think it's going to be afraid of little old me running around. Look at that. It's like a goldish one. That one is huge around, but not very good horns, I guess. Oh wow, they are all running now. Not because of me though. Is there another one over here? Wow, look at that guy. Now that seems as close to a five I've ever seen, and that's a female. I don't see a lion over there. Ooh, what's that? Oh, no, get me. Warning call. For who? That's a, okay, well, we're gonna go this way. Oh, I have the wind blowing that direction. Maybe that's what's scaring everyone. The buffalo are coming back this way. And I'm sorry I'm delving into this because I'm going to have the comparison video for everything, but, in Zambia, at the time of year we went, which was this, previous January 2019, it was the wet season, so there was water everywhere, and because of that, the buffalo were just kind of everywhere too, not like everywhere to see, but just kind of not in a group, kind of just doing whatever they want. So definitely sucked because we were hoping to see a lot of Cape Buffalo and we couldn't. I said I was gonna walk and then I started running. The Cape Buffalo are going to start coming back this way to get to back to their need zone, though. Yep, there they are. Okay, well, if we don't see any tracks from the lion, we'll just wait for those guys. Maybe the lion was chasing the Gemsbok. Let's find out. So I want to say that the direction the sound was coming from was more this area, right? I'm gonna say that was a Cape Buffalo. Going down. Okay. You know, that looks like a wildebeest. But it's a Gemsbok. Did they use the same track for the wildebeest and the Gemsbok? What was that? Okay, so they have sound, but they don't always tell you where the sound's coming from. I guess I have noticed that a couple of times with the lions. Is this? Yeah, look at that. Okay, so we got tracks. And he's running, probably from me, not chasing something. I'm gonna try to stay out of the trees, but if we need to go in them, we can. Track there. I'm gonna try to skip that one. Shouldn't have though, because I lost it. Some need zones I'm just passing up. Gemsbok are going crazy. Okay, we gotta go back and get that last track, I guess, because I just not seeing anything else. Shouldn't have skipped it. Shouldn't have skipped it. Handy dandy notebook. Clear photos of three animals. Okay. Boy, if one of them's a warthog. Okay. Whew, good deal. Because we definitely got some clear photos of those. Let's see. Well, we are within the cone. That is for sure, but we were within the cone the last time too, so it's almost the whole tracking thing again with the female. Just kind of disappear. Let's get out here and see if we can see anything from out here. There's Gemi. Gemsbok way over there. Capes are coming back. Oh, what is that guy? Female. Pretty though. Okay. That's chance for a Gemsbok there. Okay, so we need a different plan of attack here because we've come back to these tracks how many times now? And we've given up how many Gemsbok now? I say we skip these trees because they're not helping me. What the heck? Oh. Or we go this way because we haven't really been off this direction. Oh, see, look at that. Those freaking guys. Running around like a bunch of crazies. Nope, running. Ah. Nope, that was a bad shot. Ah! Really got me that time. Goodness gracious. Ah, man, it is impossible to stop these guys now without a good lung shot. Maybe a hard shot. I understand hitting the horns, but it, like, that spine. You just need to watch some videos on charging buffalo and see what the guides do, because if they can't stop a charging buffalo the way they would do it in real life, then we don't really have much of a chance. I realize that the spine shot's kind of overdone with a lot of the animals, but charging K-Buffalo is a different ball game. Okay, now how do you even attack that? Okay, so this is him going this way. And then there was tracks going the opposite way, but maybe he had a need zone and was coming back. Yeah, because this is him coming back. And this is him going out again. At a trot. So that could be him. Hard to say. There's so many tracks. Let's follow this, see how long ago this was. Just now, okay, so. Assuming he ran away from the shots. Poop doesn't give us a cone, of course. Oh my god. I just have such little health, I really can't. The lion's just gonna take me out. Okay, so we got poop. Got more poop just now. Guessing he's going towards the road. Yep, okay. See, this seems comparable in size to the last one we got. Not the female, but the last male we got. I'm trying to remember, but the 5-something or other, 526, seems similar. What was it? We'll see here. 520. It seems similar in size to the first one, right? In the tracks. He was going that way. I really didn't see him going up there. I feel like he would have gone back down this way. Unless he just trotted over that mountain really quick. Hill, sorry, not really mountain. Rat. Well, this is as good a stopping point as any. I was really hoping, with as open as this area is, we would be able to see where he went, but we're just at about the time I was hoping to stop, so. Thanks everyone for watching. As you know, this has been Bo from BZ Hub. Please like and subscribe the video if you liked it. If you didn't, then you probably know what to do. Check out our other videos. I have a top five reasons not to restart your character, and yeah, some Star Wars videos that I can't decide whether to keep going with or not. I have our beginner tips. It was my first video. I'm really sorry for anyone who watches it. There's like 78 watches or something like that. It's slow, but I promise it's thorough, and it does a pretty good job of going through a lot of things that people would take for granted, I think. But I found it important, so I put it out there for all of you, especially people starting in our new to expansive worlds. I think it's important. So yeah, give that a try. I have a second part coming out, and like I said before, I have my IRL Safari versus Vurhonga Savannah comparison video to do. So thank you all again for watching, and we'll see you later.